Hello student, myself Nimesh Prabhakar. Welcome to Antenna and Propagation lecture series. In my previous lecture, I complete chapter number 2. So, in that lecture, we have discussed about the dipole antenna, like lambda by 2 dipole antenna, or it is also known as the half wave dipole antenna. So, now we start new chapter, chapter number 4, as per the GTU syllabus. Antenna array. So in this chapter we discuss the importance of array, like why we require the array, then the different types of the array and the application of that array. So now we start this lecture. So in this lecture we discuss about the introduction of the array, then we discuss about the types of array, what are the different types of the array. And then last we discuss about the array of point source. So in this lecture we discuss these three topics: introduction of array, types of array, and the array of point source. So now we start with the introduction portion. So this is the general figure for the array of the antenna. An antenna array is a set of multiple connected antennas which work together as a single antenna to transmit or receive radio wave. So this is the definition for the antenna array. So antenna array is the multiple connection of antenna which work together as a single antenna to transmit or receive the radio wave. An antenna array is radiating system which consists of individual radiator and element, each of these radiator, while function has its own induction field. The elements are placed so closely that each one line in the neighboring one's induction field. Therefore, the radiation pattern produced by them would be the vector sum of individual ones. So when we have to increase the gain or the directivity, or in some application we require the array for the more to cover the more area, so we require the antenna array. Now we discuss about the different types of the array. So to before understand the different types of array, we can see here this is the figure of one mobile antenna. So here we can see this is the 4 different antenna they have placed. So this is nothing but they have used the different antenna to transmit and receiving. So in generally when we require the more gain or directivity of the antenna, so the single element of antenna is not capable to produce the desired directivity or the gain. So and in that case we generally use the antenna array. There are the other application of the antenna array, like in MIMO they also use the array concept, like a multiple input multiple output. Now we discuss about the type of the antenna array. So first one type of the antenna array is the broadside array. Second one is the end fire array. Next one is the collinear array. And last one type of antenna is the parasitic array. So mainly antenna array is divided in these 4 categories: broadside array, end fire array, collinear array, and parasitic array. So we understand one by one this. So first one, we start with the broadside array. So this is a type of array in which the number of identical element is placed on a supporting line drawn perpendicular to their respective axis. So here in this figure we can see this is the number of elements of the array we have placed here at the this is the axis of this antenna, and we have placed this array in a perpendicular direction. So we can see here. And the distance between this array is the d. We can see the d. And this array we have given like the axis of antenna, we can see here. So now we understand the broadside array. The element are equally spaced and the fed with a current, that means fed with a current of equal magnitude and all in the same phase. So now we have taken the assumption like the antenna that we place, like the elements are equal spaced, like a distance between them is the equal, and the current we have given that is the equal magnitude, and also the phase is the same. So the advantage of this feed technique is that array fired in the broadside direction, that means perpendicular to the line of array axis, where there are maximum radiation and small radiation in other direction. So here the radiation is maximum to the direction to the perpendicular. We can see the this is the maximum direction, this and upper side is the maximum direction. So the antenna radiate its energy maximum in these two direction, perpendicular to this, and the minimum radiation occur in this direction, that is in this axis direction. So the radiation pattern of this antenna is just like this. This is the broadside antenna radiation pattern. The radiation pattern of broadside array is bidirectional, and the array radiate equally well in either direction of the maximum radiation. So this is the radiation pattern. We can see this is the bidirectional. This is the first one direction, and this is lower one direction, second one direction, and it radiate equal power in this two direction. So maximum direction of radiation in the broadside direction, in the broadside array, in these two direction, like the perpendicular to the line of array axis. So this is the broadside array. Now we discuss about the end fire array. This is the second one type. So now we have take same assumption. The end fire array is very much similar to the broadside array from the point of view of arrangement. So here we have just placed this antenna array and the broadside array, same as in the end fire array. But the main difference is in the direction of maximum radiation. So the difference between the broadside array and end fire array is the difference in between that is the maximum direction radiation. We know that in the broadside array, the maximum radiation is the perpendicular axis. Sorry, in the perpendicular to the axis. So in the broadside array, the direction of the maxima radiation is perpendicular to the axis of the array. While in the end fire array, the direction of maximum radiation is along the axis of array. So here the first one, this figure is indicate the end fire array. So we can see here, this is the direction of maxima is the along to the axis like this. And this second one figure is the broadside array. So here the direction of maxima is perpendicular to the axis. We can see here. So this is the difference between the broadside array and the end fire array. In the end fire array, the maximum radiation is along to the axis, and in the broadside array, the maximum radiation is the perpendicular to the axis. So we can see this is the maximum radiation in this direction, and here the maximum radiation is the this direction, and minimum radiation is the same as opposite. All the antenna are fed individual with the current of equal magnitude, but their phase vary progressively along the line to get the entire arrangement unidirectional finally. That means the maximum radiation along the axis of the array. So here we have changed that. That means in the broadside array, we know that the equal magnitude, that means we have given the current with the equal magnitude and equal phase. But here we change the phase of that current with progressively along the line to get the entire arrangement. So this is the difference between the end fire array and the broadside array. Now, collinear array. This is the third one type of the array. In the collinear array, the antenna are arranged end to end along a single line as shown in figure. So we can see here this antenna we have arranged in the line end to end. We can see this is the first one, A0, A1, A2, A3 element we have placed in the vertical. Same as we can also place it in the horizontal direction like a 1, 2, 3, 4. So the individual element in the collinear array are fed with the current equal in magnitude and phase. So here we put that current in the equal magnitude and equal phase current. In collinear array, the direction of maximum radiation is perpendicular to the axis of the array. So here the direction of the maximum radiation is perpendicular to the axis of the array. So here we can see this is the direction of the maximum, that is the perpendicular to the axis. And same as when we place in the horizontal line, the direction of maximum is in the this direction. We can see this is the vertical direction, and when we place in the vertical direction, the direction of the maximum is the horizontal direction, that means perpendicular to the axis. So this is the collinear array. The collinear array has circular symmetry with main loop perpendicular everywhere to the principal axis. Thus the collinear array is also called omnidirectional array or the broadcast array, because we know that in the omnidirectional antenna its radius same like this. Now last one is the parasitic array. The array of antenna in which the parasitic element get the power through the electromagnetic coupling with driven element which is in the proximity with the parasitic element is known as the parasitic array. So the best example for the parasitic array is the Yagi-Uda antenna. So here we have fed the antenna in this driven element, and that element we radiate like in the boom side, this is director, it radiates its energy. So here the array of antenna in which the parasitic element get the power through the electromagnetic coupling. So these elements get the power through the coupling. So that's why this is known as the parasitic array. In chapter number 7, we discuss more detail, in detail discussion in chapter number 7 about this parasitic array. The common example of parasitic array is the Yagi-Uda antenna. Now, array of point source. The array of point source is nothing but the array of isotropic radiator occupying zero volume. That means the isotropic radiator that occupy zero volume, that is known as the point source. To derive different expression, following condition can be applied to the antenna. Like first one condition for this, two point source with current of equal magnitude and with same phase. Second one is two point source with current of equal magnitude but with opposite force. And last one is the two point source with current of unequal magnitude and with opposite phase. So from this condition, different condition, we derive the equation for this array point source. Like in the first one condition, we have take this, like we have two point source that we give the equal magnitude current and equal phase current. In second one, we have take this condition like two point source, we give the current of the equal magnitude but opposite phase. And last one, two point source with the current of unequal magnitude, like the magnitude of the current is not same, with opposite phase. So we will discuss about these three in next lecture. Like first we start with the two point source with the current of equal magnitude and with same phase. So in this lecture, we discuss about the introduction of the array. Then we discuss about the type of array. And last, we discuss about the array of point source. Thank you.